Testing, 1, 2, 3. This is a recording of the meeting of the Executive Board, Tuesday, November the 12th, 1963, St. Joseph's Infirmary Boardroom.
Thank you. as those, some of us have come later, are there any additional ones there? If who else might need to have a copy? I have, you know, going with Sister Kristen, I just wanted to have a copy for my dresses. Madam Chairman, I wonder if, just in view of clarity, since the written motion and the other one say essentially the same thing, but for posterity's sake, I wonder if we could delete the paragraph above. I think it, in the interest of clarity, would be best, since it's covered in the...
In my interest of time,
yeah.
I didn't have time
not
to
for now, it's
type
for
all this over again, so I just went right on.
I'm not sure that, I don't think there would be a conflict, but it is redundant.
September and October, since September 3rd over, I'm just going to give you the October report. brought forward in September $671.28 and receipts from membership dues for the balance of $63,32.50 and for 1964, $1,852.75. Miscellaneous 25, $1,910.25. $2,581.53 for total. Expenses were $808.43. Clearing the bank, $1,773.10. Checks out, $297.90. Agrees with bank statement, $2,071. Obligation to the government as a whole is $90.14. And checks out is $297.90. Official. I move that the report is set.
This means that no funds have to be borrowed at this time, doesn't it?
Not for the business.
Thank you.
We have enough then.
That by you is part of next year.
That's why I'm having the renewal for next year. That's why we're not having the meeting. We're cutting down on that. We did not need our full membership to be like originally 106.
For the professional register, this is professional register, financial report for 1963, income complete 231, billhead 22, and the practicum makes 181, and the practical billhead $6, the miscellaneous, which is posted. $440.20. Salaries $1,498.21. Telephone $48.55. Rent $125. Federal tax $352.28.
I didn't see this until just now, so that's the reason why it's miscellaneous, $18, making the whole total of expenses $2,042.04. Bouncing bank in October 1963, $4,316.63.
May I ask if you did keep a breakdown of salaries in your financial report this time? I did ask that it be attached.
Mrs. Helen Wright, $360. Mrs. Rebecca Kellum, $335. Mrs. Margaret Vandenberger, $432. Mrs. Roy Orton, $320. Mrs. Martha E. Carlton, $100. Mrs. Dollison Hinton, $250. Mrs. Agnes Stenner, $18. Mrs. Wanda Ramsey, $54. A total of $1,869 without deduction.
This memo of $18 was a check bought by a new graduate. PhD in good faith. And after going back to her hospital and doing private duty ability, she was instructed she did not have to belong to the registry to do private duty at George Baptist. So the registry committee did, for sake of public relations, we did, she did turn in and make the check good, sent another check for $18. But the registry committee did feel that due to all of the conflict concerned with it, since her hospital told her one thing and she was a new graduate, we wanted to encourage her to be a member of AMA and her state association and so forth. And she did, after she completed state board, we did agree to go ahead and just return her check for $18 that she sent in the place of the one for insufficient funds because of the conflicting statement from her hospital, and since she had not received a call from the registry but from the Georgia Baptist registry. And that's why this memo is here for the insufficient funds check for $18, and her check has been returned to her that was insufficient to the solicitor. Embarrassed to ask questions. TESR section is. Please excuse me. Thank you.
Thank you.
the large room downstairs, not the regular restaurant, but not on top of the lobby. Mm-hmm. Excuse me, Miss Hannah, but I shouldn't be talking to you. $2.80 plus 9 cents tax from the tips is amounting to $3.31.
Yeah.
We put down there $3.35.
May I ask how the ticket sales will be handled? I know that free advice is rarely appreciated, so I'll give some. As a person sat in this chair that you're now in for a good many years, we found nothing so successful as sending these to the individual with a response and, with a request to respond. And we found no way ever to avoid the thing of not really knowing how many people were coming in order to confirm reservations. Other than this, and we set a deadline on it, and I would say this works better now. Getting it out is one thing, and the ad is just first to hear.
He has the material I'm consulted the first thing in the morning.
The other was brief. Believe me, it was very difficult, and this last was so smooth, I wondered why we hadn't thought of it a long time before. And we also had a good attendance that was better.
Mm-hmm.
all due respect, and I want to certainly thank the committee for the very hard work that I know has been done. At the same time, I know that the rescue committee has done an awful lot of hard work. And I am on this board as chairman of the rescue committee only. But each girl on that rescue committee represents a group of private universities. We feel that that rescue belongs to the private universities. And according to the bylaws, present bylaws, which is supposed to be our guide, the rescue committee is responsible through the board for the operation of the nurses' professional rescue. There has been a special effort, I'm sure, made to bring all the recommendations to the board. I understand there were a few that were not brought recently, but I do know that the rescue committee was most sincere in their deliberations. And I feel like they certainly are due under a democratic process. And since information is available to the rescue committee that I feel that this was not available to the study committee, I feel like that we cannot take definite action here tonight and adopt these recommendations in whole. Now, I did come prepared with some recommendations from the rescue committee on the appointments and reappointments and resignations of people at the rescue. But I feel like that rescue committee should have an opportunity, keeping the bylaws in mind, to study these recommendations and, if necessary, sit down with this board, because it is our livelihood. We have a responsibility to the general public and to the medical association for the operation of that rescue. And I know that feeling is very high among the private nurses who do constitute the membership of that rescue, that the rescue committee continues to be the committee that makes the recommendations to the board. We are only glad for the board to offer any suggestions to us that might help us, but we do feel like that the bylaws at the present time do state that we bring the recommendations to the board, and I do not feel like I would be serving the members of this committee without I ask this board to give these recommendations very, very serious deliberation. It's a little different than other committees, because that is the place of employment for almost 500 nurses. As far as the rescue committee, there's a lot of girls that would welcome not having to work with the rescue committee. They would be glad to have someone else take their place. But I do feel that we have to maintain our rescue with the rescue committee continuing in its present status.
Well, Chairman, I mean that we actually put a re-reclamation
I'll say that.
Yeah.
Each one. Well, Madam President, I'd like to go on the point. This one is mentioned that she felt that the registry belonged to the private university.
Well,
I know, but we are a professional registry. financed by the private duty nurses, as is their livelihood.
Madam President, may I have the floor just a moment? The material that we worked with was sent to us in confidence. Many of the people that filled in asked for just 0.4.
I want to ask that. I want to know if in accepting the report, because in the report included 9 recommendations. If we vote to accept that report as the motion reads, does that mean that we automatically accept all of these recommendations?
I'd like to know if Ms. White is going to be severed of her services at that time.
That's right.
Now, is Mrs. Hooker going to take the job at the same salary that Ms. White was taking? It was my understanding that she asked for a bigger salary in her application originally.
I don't believe that's in the first motion. We can't consider that until we get to the motion.
Thank you.
accepted November 3rd, 1963.
I moved your back.
No, it was, there was so many requests that a clerk be removed and a professional person put in. But you see, they feel that is, as a whole, the money that is being used for the bookkeeper now can be saved. In fact, it's not any saved, but it just wouldn't have to borrow to pay for something that you do not have. And that some system will be worked out among the people there to take care of the bookkeeping part until the money is there to establish, and the board sees fit to reorganize and adjust it. But they're not letting the night clerk go because of salary. They're letting her go because she is not a professional person and does not know how to take care of the call from. And there was also many requests for that removal.
Also,
there's not a thing on this piece of paper that was taken out of the material that we received. I'm interested in the register because I use it.
The ninth person, Don, her salary would be less than the register salary. They would be able to keep doing it.
She's a registrar, not a bookkeeper. In fact, she doesn't do anything and doesn't handle the call, so we're informed, as a professional person would handle them. Now, we're only quoting hospital people.
Does that
take care of it?
As you know, I'm new on the Register Committee. I had nothing to do with either their success or their failure. But I do represent 500 private nurses. How will these nurses be represented? Will you appoint the representative, or will these nurses appoint the one who's representing? Well, then, after we agree to adopt this, and then see on the side of exactly what the board is going to do to you. Yes, I realize that, but you see, I automatically receive a seat on the executive board by being chairman of the private section. Therefore, I represent the private section.
What do you mean?
do about the bylaws. The bylaws say, now I understand I'm not looking or overlooking the board. I know the board has the final say, but I want an interpretation of the bylaws because I'm going to be asked a lot of questions. The registry committee shall submit nominations to the executive board for appointment of the director of registry and her assistant or assistant, shall outline duties of registrars and policies for registry operations to be approved by the executive board. Now, what happens to the bylaws? In other words, I remember quite well when the board met, I think it was at Georgia Baptist Hospital with the registry committee, and we had a decision to make about the dismissal of a registrar. The registry committee was told in no uncertain terms, it was made very plain, that they were fully responsible for the operation of that registry, and the recommendation had to come from the registry committee. The registry committee declared a recess. Well, it happened at the board, even if it was wrong. Declared a 15-minute recess and came back with the recommendation. The registry committee, when it was put to vote, there was one abstention, and there was one voting no, and the rest all voted for the dismissal. What I want to do is clarify the position. We do not want anything in the registry committee that this board does not want, but we do have to consider and the protection of the people who work from that registry. And we feel like if we're going to be a professional registry, I don't know of anyone who's more concerned with the operation of the registry than the people who make their living from that registry. So I'm asking what this bylaw means and what will we do with this bylaw if we go ahead and vote to dissolve the registry committee and we haven't done anything about the bylaw. Now that's what I'm asking here. I just want to know exactly what we're doing so when I have to make an explanation, I can make it with some sense and maybe the girls will understand.
Well, I don't believe the way I interpret this is
he
says that the registry people cannot have a registry committee because on that this present registry committee, and they say that the registry committee be dissolved in a letter written to each member. And this recommendation means the committee that she has served in at this time.
And I see nothing wrong with that. Well, the bylaws say who's to be on that committee, too.
It's made up of all the alumni.
The bylaws say who that committee is supposed to be composed of. So that's why I say, what should we do with the bylaws? If we're going to have a completely different arrangement, now if we're going to continue to have private duty nurses on that committee and follow the bylaws, the county's inspection, and an administrator and so forth, then that would not be in violation. But when we were asked what we would do about the committee, it was not clarified what the committee would be composed of. So I'm asking, I want to get the bylaws straight first.
The study committee has suggested that fire takes care of this, that the new chairman and members of the committee be appointed at a later date that will comply with the bylaws, which states that, quote, no recommendation from the nurses' professional registry covering any phase of its operation shall be binding unless these recommendations have the approval of the executive board, end of quote, as interpreted by legal counsel.
Now, I was under that impression that anything we brought had to be approved before it was binding. I don't think anyone on the registry committee doubts that. I think they all understand that the board does approve, and nothing is official until the board does. does approve. But I did want a clarification there, because I remember what happened to us a couple of years ago.
I was just thinking, like, maybe it's just a matter of terminology for them. Maybe it'd be better to say that the present membership of the Redskins Committee be dissolved. We're not going to change the whole structure. I mean, this wasn't the thinking of the Redskins Committee, the study committee, that we're going to change the whole structure of the committee, but that the membership of the present Redskins Committee be dissolved in the letter written to each member. I'd like to clarify the statement. And I would like to say, as a member of the study committee, that the private duty nurses' interests were at heart. We didn't work in a vacuum, so to speak. We certainly considered the wishes of the private duty nurses. And Ms. Mason said several times tonight that we got our information from the questionnaires that were sent to private duty nurses. They were the ones involved in this. And we certainly worked with their interests at heart. And I'd like to really emphasize that.
I'd like to know what's wrong with the members that we have on the list of committee now. The members are hardworking girls, and they represent. I know the one from Crawford Long represents the Crawford Long private leader now. So what's the matter with our base to committee to that? The members that we have on.
Again, I would say the quote
personality part.
Here's the question.
She was asking us when the question was called.
I mean, I don't know. I
understood the question was called for the vote while someone else had the floor asking a question.
Thank you. will the executive board deem otherwise? This is the new committee that you asked to be appointed last month.
I mean, that's true.
What, send me an answer.
Let's get a motion.
I move to accept.
Thank you. Since this does involve so many private e-nurses, would you tell me why we cannot have a private e-nurse on this study committee? This is a special committee appointed by the board. I asked for a volunteer to be a nurse last year. We had three volunteers the first two days, and I was asked not to be on the committee because I was asked to be on the e-nurse. We asked for volunteers.
Someone said without a private e-nurse.
Yes, they did. They did in the standards that no private e-nurse, her request was that no private e-nurse, that was in the motion.
Madam Chairman?
No, no.
As a point of information, I thought the study committee was, the reason that we asked for the private e-nurse not be appointed to investigate, I thought this was to investigate the unrest and to find out what trouble was with the registry was why, they asked the private e-nurse not be involved. Now, I think this is altogether another recommendation, isn't it? That the man from the director be directed by the executive board.
Always supposed to investigate.
You think the Monday employees, I thought.
I interpret this as to be the method by which the detention will be sought.
But I would answer it. Would the, Madam Chairman, the committee consists of those three that you appointed to investigate the register committee?
Volunteer. I asked for volunteers. I had three people volunteer.
Well, I sure wasn't me on it, but I was a private e-nurse, and they said no private e-nurse could be on it, because I wanted to be on it.
The study committee then will be. The registry study committee, which is composed of the president and sister Miss Mason, will be responsible until the board takes further action for the operation of the registry.
Okay. And you may table this and not take any more action for an indefinite length of time at this time, too?
No.
Is that right, Miss Mason? I know it doesn't say that, but it does imply it, I believe, Miss Mason. It says until the executive board deems otherwise, and you can tie it up to the executive board. At any time.
Well, we will not have another board meeting till January.
You can have a call meeting anytime you want.
Madam President. It was sort of my feeling at the last meeting that a private e-nurse did not want, did I misunderstand that, on this investigation committee, did not want to be on the committee. Is there any reason why we couldn't ask for now a private e-nurse to, well, the investigation's over, but the running goes on, that we couldn't ask for a private e-nurse or two private e-nurses to be added to this?
That was the original
I just want to make one statement. The executive secretary had no thought on it, so she already has enough headache to have a combination of offices.
Number eight, that replacement and appointment for registrars be as follows. Ms. Diana Hooker as director registrar.
I think this should be acted on second.
Ms. Dawn, I know I'm asking too much, but you know I am here. Please tell me, in consideration of this low finances up here, number two that we voted on, could we have a breakdown of the salaries on this before we vote on it? I would like to know about how much we're going to be putting out.
I have them right here if anybody wants to see.
I'll be honest, they have not been any discussion of salaries. That will come to the board at a later date because we feel we have the rest of the month. But there have not been any discussion of salaries. That is, that I haven't. Now, whether somebody else has done it or not, I don't know. But I have not discussed salaries.
That they will accept these positions before we vote on them. Have they all said
they
that they would?
They have said they would accept and help out for the time being until things are straightened out and the board knows what to, how they're going to handle things. But now whether they go back on what they said, I don't have it in writing. But I did not ask for it in writing.
What is the present salary?
Well, I wasn't asked to discuss salary.
Mm-hmm.
I don't even know the salary.
The present salary of the director.
Did I hear a motion regarding
the discussion?
Those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Contrary, no. Mrs. Rebecca Kellum, to remain for the present time, 3/11/2006.
I would like to make a statement.
There's a motion that this be accepted.
I have a letter with me from Ms. Kellum resigning as of December 31st, and I would like to make it plain to this board that both Ms. Brandenburger and Ms. Kellum notified us early in the year that they plan to resign. Ms. Kellum's children are anxious for her to give up permanent employment. Ms. Brandenburger wanted to resign a year and a half ago, but because of so many changes at the registry with Mrs. Louise White leaving the registry and then difficulty in getting someone to accept the acting chief registrar's job, Ms. Brandenburger did agree to stay on to finish out remain until such time as she could get someone to take her place. talking of retiring since last March. And she did write an official letter to Beth, but she did say that she would stay on until they could find a replacement for her. Now that's what her letter states, and I have it here. If any of the board members want to see it.
Those in favor, Mrs. Rebecca Kelly, remaining for the president, please say aye.
Aye.
Contrary, no.
No.
One distinguished vote that I heard. This motion is carried. Number three, that Mrs. Louise Song be given the ninth shift, 11:07. Discussion. Those in favor, Mrs. Louise Ball, please say aye.
Aye.
Contrary, no.
No.
Mrs. Willina Martin, relief registrar for days off. Discussion. Those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Contrary, no. Motion is carried. Mrs. Margaret Brandenberger, relief registrar for holidays and meetings.
I move that Mrs. Brandenberger be relief registrar for holidays and meetings.
Second.
Discussion. Those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Contrary, no. Motion is carried. It's carried. Eight. Number nine, that authorization be given for payment of the new registrar during the past month and for the current month. And you recall, we sent a referendum vote out to get your wishes regarding the payment of Mrs. Kent, whose application was never brought to the board or accepted. But we did not have the original scholarship to pay her check to her. What is your wish regarding the payment of the relief registrar during the past month and for the current month? And I believe was Ms. Rand, Janet, Janet, Janet,
I move the acceptance of recommendation 9.
I second.
Discussion.
That was point resolution. On payment, Ms. Dixon isn't in line right now, but I would like to know, I thought the registrars were on a set pay scale assigned. I know that the regular registrars that are, registrars that are up there,
they are on the salary.
In other words, they're not to be paid overtime. They're supposed to have comp time. Is that right?
To get this time off, no, that's even if they work overtime, they're supposed to take it in days.
fill out.
I think the treasurer has to, would be interesting to the board to hear this, and I think it's only fair that they hear it.
I believe that this motion has to do with the, checks that, we are not able to deliver because the board has not accepted this issue.
They've never been to finish. Is the board approved, the hiring of a private duty nurse in an emergency to go to the rescue work? Was that brought to the board?
Yes, after these people went.
But after this motion is cleared, as information, I think it would be well to bring this information to the board.
Well, I think it's nothing but fair that they should hear it. Is there any further discussion regarding this question or this motion? Those in favor, then please say aye.
Aye.
Contrary, no. And we have. Now we have, recommendation that the study committee of the register further recommend that in the event that the above recommendations are not adopted, that the register be closed and reordered. I believe this is necessary.
Not yet.
The above recommendations were all adopted. Now I wonder if this is having an overall motion as our policy carries to get that we accept this report.
I second it.
Those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Contrary, no.
No.
Did I hear two down there?
Three.
Three. Three.
Four.
Maybe three or four.
Four.
Four. Four. So this motion is carried. I believe that takes care of the report of the study committee.
Madam Chairman, I think about something that, one of the members just spoke about, but there is some information here on the salaries that the registrars have received in May, June, July, and August that I feel that the board is entitled to hear. It came to my attention personally just recently as I have attended only one meeting of the register committee, but I do think that this is something that we should hear.
How did you contact him?
What's that?
The report of
place, could you give that to the committee?
It has not come.
Well, we had it here and we asked it to be delivered.
It's in my, in the book.
Oh, you can hear in this book?
In that book, on the left side, on the beginning, it's a fatty, if I can. It's a fat on the right side, my thing.
January, February, March, April.
Oh, this is.
We've never been able to get any of those reports on breakdown of salaries for 3 years.
Well, we demanded them. I demanded them after I got to be chairman of the registry committee and got them.
Now, what is your question?
Ms. Mace, I would like for the board to have the information that was given to the registry committee here.
I thought each person was given,
You didn't.
You have not.
We have, and you just got it.
Oh, that's good.
I thought you want the total.
Well, these people at the registry, I understand, have been making out, they all know that they are on salaries, that they're not to be paid overtime. And some of the very personnel that we are asking to continue on made their statement out for their salaries, handed it to the bookkeeper, and they were paid tremendous amounts of money over their salaries. For instance, in April, Mrs. Orton was paid $428. Her salary at that time was $320.
May I ask a question? Did she work more hours of billing on that day?
They're on a salary, they are not allowed any overtime pay. The budget does not allow for overtime pay. They are to have their time made up to them in days off when the emergency can be taken care of.
The time wasn't always reported back to the board each month.
I asked and demanded this from the bookkeeper and I got it.
But you have only been a chairman just for the past month.
Well, that's true, but I did ask for a birthday.
But before that, when we had the registered people, they were authorized to go ahead and work. But why should they give double time by being paid? You don't.
Well, nobody expected them to work for nothing, Miss Mace, but what we couldn't understand, there was an emergency.
Yes, but they say though it was authorized by the registry committee. Now that's all I know.
I sat on the registry committee and I don't know of but one meeting that I missed. And I never heard any authorization for that.
The only one here that I see any place for an argument about is Mrs. Family Budget. Because when a relief registrar, I was on the registry committee for 11 years, and I do remember some of the things that transpired during that time. And the relief registrar, that is the one that comes just for holidays and like that, not the one that's on a salary, but the one that comes in as extra, if she relieves during the month, we'll say for a month's vacation, she is to be on a salary. That has been in the bylaws.
Oh, well, I know
now,
that.
Whether you people still have it there or not, I don't know.
Well, now, Miss Mace, listen, with all due respect, we're all aware of that, and no one here is
But Miss Van Berg, one place is almost $500 for 1 month.
Well, I'm saying, Miss Vaughn,
but why wasn't it taken care of if the registry committee was handling the business as it should be handled?
Let me say something. Please, I've been inspector. We don't have time now to go through the minutes, but we can go through the minutes and we can show you that we have not had treasurer's course from the registry committee. We had the chairman of the private session, and also had the chairman of the registry committee on the board with no treasury report here brought to the board. and many of the members here who are still in the board over this period of time will remember that we have gone without any senior report. Now, my question is this. If these people have been paid for overtime, who authorized this? Those girls did not make out their vouchers, neither did they make out the checks. Because the vouchers have been compiled using one voucher for the whole list of employees, which is not correct. We should have one voucher to support each check that is written, and not one voucher covering all the people who work in the office. Now, that has been the problem, one problem in the industry. I know nothing about this, except what's brought here. But I do know that we have gone on in these meetings now for 3 years that we have gotten these reports from the Registry Committee on Financial Reports, and I yet have to see an audit report that succeeds.
You see, I want to thank you for clarifying that to me. This is exactly what I wanted to know. And we also have on here from Ms. Bone, you know, in 1 month, $700 and something.
So I think that you can certainly see that the board is certainly in their limitations in setting up a committee to look into this. The board is solely responsible for this, the operation of the registry. It is the registry committee. The bylaws give the people on the registry committee an opportunity to come to the board and bring suggestions to the board for appointments to the committee. But the board accepts them. And these can reject them.
We have been hampered
on the board as really knowing the financial status of the
registry. This is another reason why we need some failed acts and we need some orientation materials and there will be committee not only the registry, but all committees. So people will know what their functions are and what they're supposed to do and what they're not supposed to do. And in the registry, we certainly do need on the available to all the registrars to see this.
I think that's one reason that Ms. Hampton has worked so hard trying to get together in writing all of the actions of the board for the last 20 years. And with it to you in writing, to meet people that are coming forward and to review from the older people that have been on committees for years. I wonder if you would mind listening to Mr. McClellan summarize for us at this time.
It's one time I asked to be heard from, I asked him to let me make a statement, a general statement, reference to this report and to the action that you ready to take in tonight. And I want to say in preface to this that I may be sticking my neck out in making this observation, but I've stuck my neck out before, so I don't hesitate to do it again. This is the first board meeting at which I've been in attendance. I want to make it clear and preface to what I'm going to say that I didn't know any more about this report tonight when I got here than any of you people who had not worked on the committee. I did not work with the study committee. I did not know its existence. They didn't confer with me in any way about it. All I'm trying to do is to draw certain conclusions from it, which I think will be helpful in dealing with the discussion about this, the questions that have been asked, so forth, because the one thing that I do know is that for any organization to function effectively, it must be done in that sphere of harmony and with the unity of purpose, the best interest of the entire membership. Now, this report strikes me objectively, and as I say, I still consider myself an outsider since I'm here for the first time, as being one to correct a situation about which I know nothing in the world. Apparently from the discussion, you had some difficulty in the operation of this very important function of your association, whether it has been a tragic personnel disclosure, been a failure to follow established policy, or whether even established policy is correct. Well, maybe basically that's false is another question for consideration. But for whatever reason, whatever gave rise to the motion adopted to the last meeting, there must have been a realization on the part of this board that this registry was not functioning in the proper manner and in the best interest of what you're trying to do there. Now, some of these specific things I won't refer to, but what it seems to me that you've done in answer to some of the specific questions, you found that your present registry committee or the present function of that office under your present registry committee is not the way you want. So you are not abolishing the registry committee as such as provided by your bylaws. You're merely dissolving committee as of this time and providing for an interim committee made up of these ladies who have served on the state committee to have the responsibility for the supervision of that registry until such time as this board acts to reappoint the registry committee. Let me say this, that in my opinion, that as long as the bylaws remain as they are until they're changed by the proper method prescribed, that new committee will have to be a part of the same way as has been the past. But I also get the idea that the reason that you're relying on an interim committee here, that you have in the back of your mind studying this problem and seeing if it ought not to be combined with your headquarters office and a different approach to the entire problem taken, and if it would be said at this time, or useless, I don't want to use the word good, useless at this time to appoint and get oriented a new registry committee when the entire procedure and approach to the whole problem is probably going to be changed as a result of this overall plan and schedule. I just thought I'd throw that out for whatever it might be worth. I hope that I've been tried to be impartial in whatever rulings I've made up here tonight, hearing based on what I know, what little I know about parliamentary law. But I think that y'all ought to get behind the board now and make it work in whatever else you, in whatever plan you devise as a means of carrying on this nation forward. Thank you.
Thank you.
Might I add to that, since you put wasn't at the convention, that the operating room conference group was reorganized on a state level, and I believe in the district we were talking in terms of hoping that it might be reorganized here. I think it'd be interesting to know.
I didn't like the fact that he had a meeting tonight. He was
First, I would like to thank our president, Ms. Garland, and our secretary, Ms. Atkins, and the board for their courtesy in sending in their referendum votes on the information that was circulated by the private duty section. And then I think it would be interesting to know that the GSNA in convention in Augusta, it was unanimously voted that the private duty section eliminate the statewide maximum fee for 8 hours private duty. This means, of course, that each section will set their own fee. And since there has been so much discussion about bringing things to the board, I would like to tell you that we asked Ms. Alice Barber, who was our parliamentarian, about bringing our raises to you when and if it is recommended by the private duty section. And she said that it would be brought to the board for courtesy only, because the private duty section did set their own fee. Ms. Jamie Coker was asked to send a letter to the presidents of all sections on this ruling. I have a recommendation for officials of private duty section GSNA. Do you want me to give that at this time? The 5th District GSNA Board be asked to revise the bylaws if necessary to recognize the individual nurses of the group and grant representation on the 5th District Board. The nurse to be appointed by the individual group the same as the representative from the local hospital alumni.
May I make one statement? In your manual, on page 6, you will find that you adopted take precedent over all other commitments, procedures, that it would come to the executive board and the district for approval.
That's right, Ms. Anthony.
In this district.
Yes, it says that. But Ms. Barbin ruled that it would come to you for courtesy approval only.
That's a new on policy for this district.
This has been amended in the state laws. And that is state. We still retain our minimum, but we did do away with the maximum.
You adopted a policy that it goes through the board in your manual. The manual may be changed, but at the present time, that is the law. It's just the bylaws.
Well, it does not say that the board may refuse the private duty necessary raise. This was the point that I was putting
across.
You
claimed it as recommendation, but not as courtesy information.
I said courtesy recommendation, and this is the way it was ruled by Ms. Barbin, and we have a recording of it if you would like to hear it.
Did we have a letter written to Ms. Barbin having some
rights? You will receive, Ms. Coker is sending a letter to the president of all of the board. Have you received one yet, Ms. Barbin? Well, Ms. Coker will send you a letter on this ruling. We ask you to do so.
Madam President, do we have a motion for this recommendation? Did you have a motion?
Yes, I move that this recommendation be accepted.
Let me have it read again.
The 5th District Joint State Nurses Association Board be asked to revise the bylaws if necessary to recognize the individual nurses as a group and grant representation on 5th District Board. The nurse to appointed by the individual group the same as the representative from the local hospital alumni.
Well, I have a question. Are they going to, because I'm an individual nurse, and are they going to call me and the individual nurses?
They have to meet. The individual nurses, it was embedded the notice in the paper. The other day, but they have been meeting for about 2 years at the American Red Cross.
I didn't know the individual nurses. I mean, I felt rather close to the Sophomore alumni,
committees with alumni, so this is disbanded alumni, they are all members of this district, they're not left alone, they're members of the.
If I don't see right eleven, it takes me.
But that's for the five years, that's only on five years, a week, that's the way they have individually.
Well, five years, long to long.
Yes. About a year ago, when the alumni went out of existence as far as A and A was concerned, as being the first unit of national membership, there was some discussion at that meeting when the bylaws were changed that they should go a little bit further and eliminate alumni representation as such. And a few years ago, I remember when the alumni president did come on the board, but when this was changed last year, it was mentioned at the time, but there was no, it didn't come through the bylaws committee, it came through some individual members, and that probably we should go all the way and really let the district be the first unit of national membership. But of course that would, if that is desirable, then it should go to the bylaws committee for consideration.
I'd like to support Ms. Wells' statement here. I think that the time has come and has gone in which we really need to, well, to look as a group at things. I really feel that all of us, to an extent, should first remember that we are nurses. I don't mean to lecture in here. And there are a great many people around this table tonight who would come under the category of individual members. I have long felt that we are cutting out some very worthwhile contributors to our organization by the present framework under which we operate, and I would be heartily in favor of anything that will make this a more representative thing. I believe that I happen not to be an individual in terms of being a graduate of a school outside the Atlanta area, but if I were, I think that I would be a little resentful and feel that I were against a closed shop sort of thing. Whether or not the alumni we let go with one hand and we're holding with another to the same thing. I'm just speaking in favor of a look at the bylaws in terms of representation on the board to include the best prepared, most representative nurses, a good sprinkling of these people, however.
Does that happen if you're going to have more DCs and DCs in the A&A? And what I was gathering from the convention in the A&A was for you to go out the members, not get rid of them. And if you're going to keep throwing them off the representation, how are you going to get members? Because as a president of Cross Along Alumni, I go back and tell what goes on with these board meetings. I don't know what someone is doing.
That was
a
good
thing. I go to the convention, and when I see in the hall, I'm telling all the things. I see this. I don't need to sit from here. And try to encourage them to come to the meeting.
Are you ready to vote on this motion?
Yes, it was me, okay.
Miss Susan said motion, or this motion. He said, I always
thought
we've been talking about it. And now I'm going to go.
this recommendation be accepted and that then it be referred to the Committee on Bylaws for study.
So that's in part of the plan, I move that this recommendation be accepted.
No.
Received.
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 Thank you, that's a better word. I think I was copying you too.
When you heard this motion, my father and Karen read the first one out of the way.
We expected it, we saw it.
Right. Is there any further discussion? Those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Those say nay.
And Madam Chairman, I would like to move too that it's a good thing in a way. I know we felt so at the time, but there has been some discussion both ways about the district and First Unit and National membership, and that in the bylaws committee stated that they also consider a representation on the board and see whether it's an out of proportion advantage to alumni to have representation on the board, or that that should be considered in bylaw study.
I
minute with your approval. And the educational director included the rest of the asked to work with the chair on program committee for continuation of our clinical excellence.
Howard. Howard.
We need a chairman for our official publication. Three were named. The chairman declined. You can sure wish that one of the three who accepted be asked to serve as chairman.
Yes, I think that we don't need a large committee here anyway that I can
take.
Mrs. Blake has declined altogether. Madam Chairman, Miss Cynthia Mallory has long been interested in this area, and I would like to suggest her as chairman. Cynthia Mallory, she's an associate professor.
I'd like to suggest Ms. Jean Copeland. I have not gotten her permission.
And Margaret Ford.
family present, Mrs. Parker's name didn't show, Mrs. Margaret Parker, and she said, and I think there was on the front of the minute. I didn't give it, it's really not a correction of the minutes, it's just an addition to the,
oh,
think
yes,
those
we
are Mrs. Margaret Parker. She's our roll call. Yes, I have no son roll call.
Madam President, I would like to tell the board that the 5th District Private Duty Section had a member who was the recipient of the Nurse of the Year Award, of the Private Duty Nurse of the Year Award this year. Ms. Emma Burns, the judge of the council, received the Paul Revere Bowl, and we're just real proud. We think she was very deserving. We're real proud of her.